Have you imagined, or is your plan for 2025 to get more involved in AI and potentially land a career in AI industry? If that's the case, you're not alone. But here's the major problem. Breaking into AI can feel overwhelming. The resources are scattered, the path isn't always clear, and knowing where to start is half the battle. That's where Andrew Ng's free book comes in. In today's video, I'm simplifying his insight into actionable steps so you can confidently kickstart your AI career in this year. Let's dive in. For those who don't know who Andrew is, Andrew Ng is one of the world's leading AI experts, co-founder of Cost Area, and former head of AI at Google and Baidu. He's taught millions through his online courses and written this free book to help people like you break into the AI field. If anyone knows how to build a career in AI, it's him. Let's start with why AI is transforming the way we learn and work with technology. In most traditional programming courses, you learn by building things like video games or websites. It's a great way to learn the basics. But AI takes this to the next level by teaching computers to learn directly from data without needing to program every single step. Think of it this way. Traditional coding is like writing a detailed recipe step by step. AI flips the process. Instead of writing the recipe, you provide the ingredients, your data, and let the computer figure out how to make the dish. This is why AI is such a game changer. It's not just about coding anymore. It's about solving real-world problems in entirely new ways. From detecting diseases to optimizing supply chains, AI is unlocking opportunities that were impossible before. And that brings us to the foundation of AI, any AI career, learning the right skills and working on impactful projects. Building a career in AI might feel overwhelming, but Andrew Ng breaks it down into three key steps. Step one, learn foundational technical skills. If you're new to AI, don't worry. Start by learning programming languages like Python, understanding basic machine learning concepts, and get hands-on with tools like TensorFlow or PyTorch. Even if you are only dabbled in coding, you're already on your way. Now, there are hot discussions on using Cursor for coding. Remember, it's a tool as well. Step two, work on projects. Real-world projects are where the magic happens. Instead of focusing on AI theory, look for practical problems that you can solve. For example, imagine a company struggling with slow customer support response times. Could AI help automate responses and improve customer satisfaction? Step three, find a job. Here's the thing, a compelling resume and portfolio of real-world projects are your golden ticket into the AI field. Networking also plays a huge role. Meetups like Pi and AI or online communities are fantastic ways to connect with people who can open doors. The best part, these steps build on each other. The skills you learn feed into the project you build, and the projects you build makes your resume stand out. Next, let's talk about how to turn those projects into real-world impact. When it comes to real-world projects, here's where most people get stuck. They try to solve abstract AI problems instead of focusing on practical, business-driven challenges. The first step is to identify a business problem. For example, maybe an online store is struggling with abandoned shopping carts. That's not an AI problem. It's a business problem, but AI can help. Next, brainstorm AI solutions. Could a recommendation system bring back customers for those people who abandoned the cart? Could predictive analytics improve inventory management? then assess feasibility and value. Not every idea will be practical. Ask yourself, do you have enough data? Do you have the right tools and budget to make it work? Once you've got a plan, break it into milestones. If you are building a chatbot, your first milestone might be gathering a data set of customer questions. Milestones keep you on track and help you see progress. Finally, plan your resources. What tools, teammates or computing power will you need? Think of it like planning a road trip. You wouldn't hit the road without mapping your route and packing supplies, right? So with those steps, you are not only building the best projects, but also gaining the confidence to take on bigger challenges. And that's where execution strategies comes into play. Now, there are two major strategies when it comes to executing AI projects. The first is ready, aim, fire. So this is a careful, methodical approach where you validate your ideas thoroughly before committing. It's great for projects where mistakes are costly, like medical AI or financial applications. The second is ready, fire, and aim. So here you jump into development and figure things out as you go. It's ideal for fast-moving industries or experimental projects. You make mistakes, but you also learn quickly and adapt on the fly. Both approaches have their place. If you're new to AI, start with smaller projects and focus on precising decisions. As you gain experience, you can take bigger risks and experiment with faster iterations. The key is to know which approach fits your project and skill level. And speaking of skill level, what if you're just starting out or looking into transitioning to AI? Let's talk about how to make that leap. Transitioning into AI might sound daunting, but Andrew Ng has a simple piece of advice. Focus on changing either your role or your industry. Just don't to do it both at the same time. So here it what that means. If you are already in tech, like as a software engineer or as a designer, stay in the same industry, but shift your role to something AI focused. Maybe you move into a data science or machine learning engineer position. On the flip side, if you're already in an industry like healthcare or finance, leverage that expertise. Instead of switching out of your field, use AI to solve problems in the industry that you already know. This approach minimizes risks and helps you build on what you already know. Now, here's another important factor to consider: big companies versus small companies. Big companies tend to have structured roles. You might specialize in a narrow area like fine-tuning AI models. This can be great for deep learning in one specific field. Small companies are more flexible. You're more likely to wear multiple hats, giving you a broader range of experiences in a shorter time. For example, if you're a data scientist, if you're a data analyst at a startup, you could take on AI projects that optimize marketing campaigns or customer retention strategies. It's a stepping stone towards a more focused AI role later on. Whichever path you choose, remember, the key to success is combining your existing skills with the new AI expertise. And while your personal skills matter, there's something else that can make or break your journey, your community. So here's the powerful insight from Andrew Ng's book. The people around you will shape your career more than you think. Instead of focusing on building a massive personal network, shifting your focus to building to building up communities that you're part of. Why? Because when you help others, you naturally create communities, opportunities for yourself. Take meetups like Pi and AI, for example. These are great spaces to learn, collaborate, and connect with people who share your interests. By contributing to discussions or even organizing a meetup yourself, you build trust and relationships that can open doors later on. And it's not just about meetups. Online forums, group projects, and even workspace collaborations all fall into this category. So the more you help others succeed, the more they'll want to see you succeed too. Here's a simple example. Imagine you are working on a team AI project and you go out for your way to help the teammate debug their model. Later, the same teammate might recommend you for a role that they hear about. It's a virtuous cycle. Lift others and you will find yourself lifted too. Now, let's zoom out and talk about the bigger picture, how to tie everything together and build a fulfilling AI career. Building a career in AI is a journey, and like any journey, it's made up of steps. Here's your roadmap. First, learn the fundamental skills, programming, machine learning, and AI tools that those are your starting point. Next, work on projects that solve real-world problems. Focus on practical business-driven challenges that demonstrate your ability to create value with AI. Then, build a strong portfolio and use it to find job opportunities. A great resume paired with networking, both online and offline, can open doors for you first or next AI role. But remember, it's not just about skills or projects. The communities you're part of and people you are helping along the way will just as important as your technical expertise. Here's the best part. Andrew Ng has already laid all this out in his free book. If you haven't downloaded it, do it now. It's packed with practical advice and actionable steps to help you succeed in AI. And here's my final thought. AI isn't just a career. It's a way to solve problems, create impact, and make the world better. So whatever you are on your journey, take the next steps today and your future will thank you. Thanks for watching and I'll see you in the next video. Ciao.